I'm Dr. Sunil Richardson. I'm an maxillofacial surgeon working out of South India in Muscat in the Middle East. So we have a baby today. This is a 10-month-old kid. We're going to do a cleft palate repair. This patient has an unilateral complete white cleft palate. We did the cleft lip for the kid a few months ago, and the kid was around 3 months of age and it reached 5 kilos of weight. As far as palatoplasty or palatal repair is concerned, I like to do it when the child is just around 10 months of age before the child starts to speak. Come and have a look at how the palate is.
I've just given local anesthesia now, even though we are under general anesthesia, because it's very vascular. So we want to be sure that we lose as little blood as possible. In a lot of our cases, we don't even lose more than 15-20 ml nowadays, because we have very good anesthesia and also because the surgery is done in the right plane. It's going to be a muscle-based repair. So it's going to be a three-layered repair in the posterior aspect. The critical thing for any palate repair is that the patient speaks well. All that you need, all that the patient ever needs is right there. It's only furled up. So this surgery is about unfurling it, getting the muscles in the right position, and to ensure that the patient gets a normal anatomy. And if that's done, nature and growth will take care of the rest. And these patients don't have any issues with speech or with anything else if we do a right proper surgery at the right time.
I would be stitching these muscles on to the other end. I started my dissection. Again, I'm using my left hand now because this is on the right side of the patient.
Similar dissection has been done on this side also. Because it's a white palate, you have to make it free. There should be no tension. And I'm using this instrument, it's the Mitchell's, to now go beneath and behind the pedicle. So I'm doing the closure of the nasal layer. The nasal layer is extremely, extremely thin. I mean, its area is even probably less than half a millimeter thin. You see this area, it's like so super thin. And so you've got to be very careful to make sure you don't tear it. Because again, with the tear in the nasal layer, the incidence of fistula formation is higher. Come down now and have a look at him. There's not much swelling all right for him. I don't think it should be only one side of the mouth. The uvula from the back side. That's the nasal aspect, which you won't be able to see once I turn it over. And it's essential that even though you don't see it, you suture it perfectly, because that will make sure a patient gets a good speech. So now I'll show you how it looks from inside. This is the, it's like a pocket if you see now. It's the nasal layer done. And even though it was so wide, you see now we're going to get the muscles ahead in the next stage. So all the muscles are free. And you see how it's moving posteriorly. And that's the area where you want to get the sling eventually. The tensor vela palatini and the levator vela palatini muscles. And so, you see that? You have to recreate the sling. They're all dissected and free now. The next step is to put the muscle stitch, after which this will automatically come close. The pedicles have already been dissected free. There's no tension if you see already. You are defining stitches. You can already see how the muscles have formed like in a natural palate. The ulna needs to be stitched on this aspect, the oral aspect. I will do that a little later. You can see the two pedicles, how it's sitting free. So the soft palate comes till here. I'm going to put one more stitch there and then pin this down onto the soft palate. And then we'll work our way up to the hard palate. So you can see that I've got a nice complete closure, tension-free closure. These two lateral releasing incisions, they're going to heal by secondary intention. They heal pretty quickly. It takes about a week or 10 days at most. All of these sutures, none of them have to be removed. That will fall off after 3 weeks. So we've done a muscle-based palatoplasty here. You can appreciate that in the way the muscles are aligned. The tensor valley palatini, levator valley palatini, musculus uvulae. And from here, the hot palate is closed in 2 layers. And from there down, it's 3 layers. Patient would stay over with us for a couple of days, and then they can go home.
So I'm just applying some pressure for this patient on whom we've done a cleft palate repair.
You see this? So that's how you would want the palate to be before the baby is extubated. I don't keep any gauze or any material there. We just make sure there's no ooze at the time when the patient's pressures are normal. Check if there's no ooze, and then we extubate the patient. Once the patient is in the ICU in the recovery, after a few hours, we even let them feed from the patient's mom. There's no problem with feeding. We can get little ooze, especially in patients like this, where you see the pedicle exposed there. That's going to heal very quickly as well. Another 5 days to a week, you don't see the pedicle. You have a lot of granulation tissue, and that's healing by secondary intention. You can have a look at the uvula and the soft palate here. This is the hematoma from the injection. Otherwise, you can see how we have a nice uvula, the midline. The muscles are all forming the new grooves there. That's the curvilineal hammer type effect, which we need for the patient to speak well.